as you heard, a photography and picture recognizing the novel A Time of Death by Dobrica Ćosić. The First World War was a real historical event, an event of public interest is the central motif of the novel A Time of Death by Serbian novelist Dobrica Ćosić. This author is one of the most widely read writers in the former Yugoslavia, which is confirmed by the data about circulation, prices, and reception of his novels. A lot of questions are often asked concerning the popularity of his work and its high circulation figures, but also concerning their artistic value and social engagement. Controversy followed each of his novels as the author's prominent position in society, literature, and culture of Serbia in the period from 50s to the end of 20th century. Ćosić entered literature from politics as a prominent member of the Communist Party during and after Second World War, and that connection with politics was not interrupted until the end of his life. And perhaps the most interesting to mention here would be his position in the president of Federal Republic of Yugoslavia 1992 to 1993. The fact that the interpretation of his work has always been defined by ideological speech seems to be the reason that he is often considered unread author. This challenging research circumstances has arisen from the basic writer's position, from the position of a writer who speaks to history as someone who participated in making of that history, and from the standpoint of the man of the government. Therefore, his work is beginning to be challenged by an expected side as a generator of ideology that produced historical conflicts in the end of 20th century. All Ćosić novels, and their number is not small, as you can see on this slide, thematize certain historical events and social phenomena. Very early, Ćosić came up with the idea of creating the novel cycle, which would be the poetic transposition of Serbian history from the 19th century to the modern days. He realized that idea, and the novel A Time of Death takes a central position in the cycle. The focus of creating motivation and writer's imagination was the transposition of history, so to realize the relationship of reality and fiction, that is, the way these two categories function in the work, imposed as a reasonable starting point for his political analytic perception and beyond for reconstructing the creative poetics of the writer. After examining the numerous articles of literary criticism about the novel Time of Death, it can be observed that the problem has been discussed by almost all critics who have written about the novel. In addition, it should be noted that Ćosić himself considered determinating the relationship of reality and fiction a fundamental assumption of any poetic novelist who would write a so-called historical novel. In the novel Time of Death, which we choose as a subject of our study, we try to answer the question mentioned to the character analysis, and in that context, documentary analysis, that the artistic features of different types of documents incorporated into the narrative tissue of the novel. The ambition of our paper is to offer a reading based on the methodology of the study of literary text that comes from the heart of post-classical cognitive narratology, a special food called in typology of characters as translated identities of Hilary Dunaway. This should lead us to the conclusions about the essential characteristics and artistic value of the novel A Time of Death. Character analysis makes it possible to consider on a micro level ratio of the photography pictures, most notably by seeing the manner in which so-called historical characters were realized compared to the non-historical characters. That is, extra-textual versions, characters which were created as a transfer of real historical, real historical figures. Yes. for example, characters of the president of Serbian government, Nikola Pašić, and Duke Živojinović, compared to intertextual versions that represent variants of unreal individuals within the actual and virtual narrative world of the novel A Time of Death. Although both are results of creative imagination, the appearing of textual versions, on the one hand, the question of the relation of the prototypes, it has real historical figures that live under those names, and on the other hand, relation to completely fictional characters produced on pure imagination within a novelistic narrative. Consideration of this issue in connecting with the characters reveal much about Ćosić's relation to a number of historical facts and data, which in a certain way had to find their place in his novel. The First World War is a general historical frame of the events described in the novel. Ćosić opted for an artistic transposition of the first 2 years of the war, 1914 and 1950, namely for the period that followed Serbian victory at Zagreb, when Serbian army and people were about to face a new offensive from the opponents, and the hell began to realize the tension of accepting some unacceptable demands. The dramatic period of difficult political, diplomatic, military decision, which ultimately at the end of 1950 led to the tragical withdrawal of the army and the people beyond the borders of their own country through icy mountains of Albania, the event in many ways unique in the history of wars, known as Albanian Golgotha, affected Ćosić very inspirational in the creative sense. This is a general novelistic plan in which the characters of the novel A Time of Death act. Actually, all time, narration in the novel takes place on two levels, a general, modern historical level, and an individual level. The intertextual transfer of the identities of heroes and characters of historical figures operate on both these plans by connecting them. This duplicity, which was carried out at all levels of novelistic structure, was achieved by applying the so-called counterpoint method. It is incorporating more different voices according to the laws of harmonics, as well as the construction which operates on the principle of bipolarity or opposition or contrast, and particularly in the characterization. It can be said that these are the basic principles of the text organizer. Historical documents which are entered in the text function in a similar way. They are also strongly meaningfully opposed to the intent of the text in which they are integrated, that is, to the reality as it is formed in the novel. All events artistically perceived in the novel basically represent the authentic historical facts. Creative training for the realization of the overall artistic visions that would leave a strong impression of truthfulness, veracity, almost entirely approaches narrative flows to historical chronology of events, and in all four books of the novel, events take place in order they took place in reality. That is, in the way it was testified by historiographical facts. The illusion of the authenticity of the novel is achieved, among other ways, by using different forms of documents. It has by using documentary techniques. It is not difficult to see that a very high level of real and fictional documentary was achieved in the novel A Time of Death. The reader's attention is also drawn to both types of documents by the fact that they are visually graphically isolated, printed in italic. The narration is occasionally entirely left to origin documentary material, that is, it is replaced by it. Therefore, it should be noted that the document is not functioning as an illustration, but is introduced thoughtfully and with a clear creative intention to illuminate the time, events, and the people in a new way, by offering a different point of view and pointing to different attitudes toward events. And this is its particular aesthetic and receptive patterns. The time of death is another, with there has been a complete synthesis of factual and fiction, real and invented. So these two categories are really difficult to separate. No historical fact, which was the starting point of the work of the writer's imagination, was not incorrect. It was genuine, and yet it was all upgraded in a special way. In the context of the newly created artwork, each used document, each well-known historical fact presented to the novel, received a new meaning, different from the one that had in the exact work of historiographical facts. The precise language of history has become a more meaningful language of literature. Specific events, places, and personalities also bring certain universal meaning, and the reader is engaged not only intellectually, but also emotionally. At the same time, the presence of various forms of historical records in the novel impacts on its entire structure, causing the development of those parts of the text that are purely imaginary, such as plot, summary, non-historical characters, forms of relation, description and representation of heroes, psychological conditions, etc. In this context, what is especially interesting is the way in which characters have been achieved, particularly extratextual transfer of the identities under the names of important historical characters from the period of First World War. A good explanation of the relation between documentary and fictional in the characterization was given by the writer himself. The children of Duke Živojin Mišić presented him that the novel did not present their father accurately. Ćosić replied that it was not their father, but his Živojin Mišić. Thus, this character and others as extratextual version of historical figures were created by creative transfer of factual to fiction. They are exactly like the writer imagined them, based on the knowledge of authentic historical material rather than what they really were. Complete authenticity is almost impossible, but when it comes to art, the novel, it is not even desirable. As a very good example of literary design of extratextual identity, we can take the example of Nikola Bašić. In the first book of the novel, he is dominant and realistic individual. Thanks to his character, his present in the actual and the virtual world of narrative, the novel has introduced a large number of authentic historical facts, as well as some other extratextual identities, historical figures, with whom he was in contact. The reader, for example, follows Pasha's telephone conversation with Duke Putnik, in which the two discuss the situation on the front, or Pasha's interview with reporters and the statement the Serb would win. The same is true for a large number of other characters, not only extratextual. We conclude that the real documentary features in the novel The Time of Death are extratextual transferable identities of the main, supporting, and episode characters, then cities, sites, taverns, front lines, and historical documents in their original forms. On the other hand, the features of fictitious documentary are private correspondence between characters and parts of their personal diaries. Letters are the most common form of non-fiction in the novel structure. Through this, characters with personal and individual plans speak about the life and the visions of the situation in which they are. In addition to being a form of auto-characterization of the hero, subjective visions always reveal a terrible war background, the general plan, anxiety, uncertainty, aversion to things that cannot be influenced. The complex relation between the events, the heroes, and the politics in the novel Time of Death have been established according to the rules of the genre of historical novel. Thanks to the privileged position of a large number of characters and critical historical distance, the structure of novel is primarily a dialogue and a character encyclopedia. As for the aforementioned privileged position of the characters, it should be said that to Ćosić it is not important what that his hero is to the world, but above all, what the world is to his hero and what he is to himself. Therefore, the world is usually shown from the perspective of the characters, often in function of their metaphorical characterization, with a small number of descriptions given from the perspective of an omniscient narrator. Each of the characters, as a carrier of one narrative flow, dominates in a certain part of time and space in which it is projected, giving it strong individual characteristics. The general pictures of time and events is achieved by incorporating the individual fate of a large number of characters into the realistic form. In one of many autopoetic texts, Ćosić says, among other things, that the advantage of historical mode is seen in the ability to express the multiplicity of human existence, the historical totality. Ćosić continues to explain the inevitable transformation of the historiographical facts, which happens in the literary work, even when the writer does not want to change anything. The best in literary work is not a reality as actuality, but a probability and possibility, another reality. This transformation into another reality, creating a new, essentially unknown world, leads to the abolition of historical facticity, which actually means the elimination of historical as such in an established work of art. It is that is why Ćosić talks about so-called historical novels, or places the phrase historical novel in quotes. When it comes to extra-textual narrative identities that appear as a protagonist of the novel, Ćosić says that they are real only concerning the generality of the meaning of their narrative features and functions, and that he performed their transposition in accordance with his philosophical and poetic ideas and dramatic structure of the novel. Therefore, one may inquire about the meaning of the knowledge of firing by comparing the literary character with the historical prototype which was based on. In fact, until the established historical truths are not betrayed, especially in the major facts, such a comparison and research is questionable, even evident. The reader of the novel finds himself in the front of a literary character, accomplished according to the writer's historical knowledge and literary talent, and therefore he should not be that interested in how genuine the accomplished character is compared to the real personality who is its prototype, but how genuine, convincing, and believable that character is in the world of creative literary work. Thank you, and sorry for my bad English.